welcome to Hot Weekly.
Everyone, I'm Jonathan.
I'm Crystal.
And this is Haunt Weekly, a weekly podcast for the haunted attraction haunted entertainment community. Whether you're an actor, owner, or just plain aficionado, we aim to be a podcast for you. And we return to you. This is technically our third podcast recording in isolation social distancing times.
Yes.
Kind of interesting how little our life has changed in some ways.
Yeah. Well, and in some ways,
it's changed drastically.
It's changed a lot.
Yeah. But other than, you know, not being able to go to our bars.
Right.
Don't think we're missing much on the in-person socialization.
Oh. No, I don't feel like I'm missing out on it.
No. But anyways, so yeah, this is the third week of our social distancing isolation. I really don't have a follow-up for that, other than to say, please take a moment, check us out at hauntweekly.com, check up on us, make sure we're staying sane, give us positive thoughts and messages. You can also talk to us at facebook.com/hauntweekly, twitter.com/hauntweekly, youtube.com/hauntweekly is our YouTube channel. All of our previous episodes are available there. And on we're also on iTunes, Google Play, and Stitcher.
Yes.
My tongue tried to slip into Bull Hillbilly right there. That's interesting. All right. Now, with this episode, we have a couple items of housekeeping before we kick this thing off properly.
Right.
So, the first one, we'll do the good news first, the great news even.
Okay.
Because, or do you want to do let's flip the order. I have them in the notes.
Okay.
Because people are probably going, where's our conference reminders?
Yeah, exactly.
And the thing is this, we talked about it. We're not going to do conference reminders for a bit.
Yeah.
We will update you on conference changes. We're going to be doing that in just a hot minute.
Right.
But it seems kind of weird to us to do conference reminders when what we say in the reminder could literally change next week.
Exactly.
Basically, all of the May conferences have been moved or changed
or canceled.
And now we're starting to see our June ones getting shuffled around, too.
Right.
So, long story short, it doesn't feel right to give a conference reminder, knowing that right now, with everything being kind of up in the air, those conferences could literally change, even in between when we record and publish.
Right. Everything is definitely possible.
We work hard to give you the most accurate information we can.
Yes.
This situation, because of its fluid nature, is very frustrating in that regard.
Yeah.
Because think about how stupid you were 2 weeks ago.
Mm-hmm.
Now think about how stupid I feel talking about conferences that are 2 months down the road.
Right.
It's exactly. Basically that. Now, that said, we do have a couple of conference announcements worth going into real fast. And substitution of our conference reminders.
Right.
Since we last spoke, and we last spoke to you 2 weeks ago, was our last episode. Chris Gay was on. We didn't do any conference reminders then.
Right.
And honestly, I don't even know. We recorded the interview with Chris super early.
Yeah.
I think it was like Tuesday or Wednesday. We usually record the weekend before. So I don't even know if it had happened when we got the chance to record.
Right.
But anyways, Ohio Halloween and Haunters Convention has been canceled. The people behind it say that the venue has canceled all events for the next 90 days, including theirs.
Mm-hmm.
The West Coast Haunters Convention has also canceled and is promising a return in 2021. And that takes out all the May conferences we had. Unfortunately, and I'm really, I feel very, very bad for both of them, but Ohio HHC, this is a new conference. They've really been struggling and really, you know what I mean, working their asses off to get this thing going and showing some great success.
Right.
And this sucks, you know?
It does.
Like, I know, I have complete confidence West Coast will be fine, that they'll come back and they'll be fine, but Ohio HHC, I hope they're able to come back next year and show them what's for. Now, that said, the other update we have is Midwest Haunters Convention, which was in supposed to be in June, is still on. But they have pushed it back to July 24th through the 26th and have moved it to the Donald E. Stevens Convention Center in Rosemont, Illinois. Rosemont is a little bit north of Chicago, where Schaumburg, where it was previously in the Schaumburg Convention Center, I think, or something like that.
Right, exactly.
Schaumburg is more west. I'm having to do the northeast, southwest in my head. West of the city. We actually stayed in Schaumburg. Lovely town.
Yes.
But I don't think we ever got into into Rosemont. But still, so they've changed locations and they changed dates, but they are still on. And this is kind of getting hyped as the substitute for Transworld, as it's looking less and less and less and less likely Transworld's going to happen at all this year.
Right. And the Midwest Haunters Convention is going to be now the same weekend as the Texas Haunters Convention. So if you were looking forward to going to both, you're probably going to have to choose one.
Yeah. Honestly, those two are far enough apart geographically.
Right.
I don't see it as a big problem. But I don't know. I don't know how many people were even planning on going to both. So maybe I'm the idiot.
No.
But yeah, in all seriousness, that's the update on Midwest Haunters Convention. Michigan Haunt Fest, that's the camping thing we talked about. It sounds really, really cool. It is still on, and it will be taking place in late June, but once again, situation's fluid. If you're going to it, stay on top of it.
Right.
We are only a weekly show, and I'm just realizing through this how limiting that is in some ways.
Yeah. Yeah, this thing has been changing hourly.
Yeah.
I wouldn't even say day to day.
These past 2 weeks have been the longest 5 years of my life. I don't know about you.
Yeah.
It's a little bit nuts. So yeah, I would honestly, if I were you guys, I would say any conference between now and August, even like beginning of August, just assume it's up in the air.
Yeah.
And keep following and checking. Follow their social media. Get alerts. Make sure you figure out what's going on, and you know.
Yeah.
Stay on top of it, because the situation is very, very fluid, and one of the things that's kind of difficult right now is different parts of the country are at different stages with this. Like here in New Orleans, we've been a hot spot for a while, so we're kind of further along in a lot of ways.
Yeah, we've been in the news about how much of a hot spot we are.
I think we're a few weeks ahead of a lot of other places that are just now starting. Like at that, my brother just texted. He lives in Maryland. He just texted me saying they just now got put on the stay-at-home order in Maryland.
Mm-hmm.
And it's like, really? We've had ours for 2.5 weeks now?
No.
Something like that?
At least, yeah.
Something like that? So, yeah, I mean, it feels like 10.5 years, and I don't know why time is passing so slowly.
Oh.
But it is.
It hit at a weird time.
But yeah, regardless. So basically, don't assume just because it's done in one area, it's going to be done in the area your conference is in.
No.
Stay on top. Follow the instructions. We will provide updates as we can on this, but obviously, this is such a fluid situation. A weekly podcast is limited in what we can do here, so do your own stuff, too. Back us up on this, and if you got any updates, anything you find out, let us know. Once again, Haunt Weekly on Twitter, Haunt Weekly on Facebook. Drop us a line. Give us updates. We have a contact form at hauntweekly.com. I confirmed it worked. We got an email recently. Responded to it.
I didn't see it.
I probably should. Well, that probably is why. Then maybe it didn't work as well as it should have. The point I'm getting at is, so we know that works. So we're, you know, let us know, give us updates, help us out. But yeah, no conference reminders for a little bit. None of the formal coming up next and da da da. We're not going to do that because it's going to get fuckered in about 5 minutes, and I just know it. It feels like tempting fate right now.
No.
All right. The other item of housekeeping. This is the fun one.
Yes.
The good one. We are doing a virtual haunt tour. We are in a very weird position among haunted attractions, especially home haunts.
Right.
In that we have a completed haunt.
Yeah.
Pretty much. It needs a little clean out, and it may be a little dirty when we're doing it.
Yeah, I'll probably do some clean out tonight.
But the point is, the haunt is built. It's ready. All the scares, all the painting, all the decoration, for the most part, is done.
Yeah, there's some detailing work.
There's some detailing,
I'd like to
do. But I mean, in the big scheme of things, compared to where we normally are in April, May,
yeah,
in March, April, and all that. Yeah, no, this is we've gone into October with an empty garage. So,
yeah.
You know, I'm right.
I know.
No, we have a mostly completed haunt. And we had the idea, hey, you know, haunters looking for things to do while social distancing and all that, we can do a virtual haunt tour. So we are going to do it tomorrow, Tuesday, March 31st, at 8 p.m. Eastern Time, 7 p.m. Central Time. We're going to do it on our Facebook page. It's going to be a Facebook Live event. I may see if there's a way to simultaneously stream to YouTube, but the event is on our Facebook page. It's pinned at the top. Facebook.com/HauntWeekly. Mark yourself as interested. Get a reminder. It'll let you know when we're getting ready to go live. We'll go live at about 7 p.m. Central Time. And my anticipation is we'll kind of faff around for a bit, let everyone show up.
Yeah.
And I don't know how long. I have no idea how long it's going to take. I'm shooting for anywhere between half an hour to an hour.
Yeah.
Because I know when we did the haunt contours, we had to like crank motherfuckers through this thing.
Right.
Because we had a long line. With this, I want to take our time. I want to talk about things and show things off.
Yeah. Well, and with the personal haunt contours, when we had the smaller group of just people that we had met through here, you know, it was much slower and more of a natural pace.
We're going to try to do more of that than...
Exactly.
So, and I also, between everything we're hoping to show off, I think it's going to take about 30 minutes to an hour, somewhere in that range.
Yeah, and we'll stick around afterwards and answer questions. Or
the tentative plan is we're going to have a laptop available. You or I or one of us will be monitoring the chat and being able to respond more quickly there.
Right.
Because one of us will be doing it on our phone. I mean, this is not going to be a scientific operation.
No.
I need one of those selfie sticks. I can hold it way out here. And
exactly.
That's what the selfie sticks are for, right?
It is.
So yeah, the plan right now tentatively is I'll be doing the tour. Crystal will be running chat and also helping demonstrate scares and helping explain things. But I'll be the one holding the phone.
Yeah.
So you'll be looking in my ugly mug most of the time. And Crystal will pop in and out as needed to talk about things, explain things, demonstrate things. And we'll probably go between that and the chat.
Right.
She'll be moving a lot. That's what it looks like.
Yeah, that'll just be like, you know,
haunt season. Just a regular haunt season.
Having
haunt open. I don't see why that'd be different. But yeah, the only favor we ask is this, just to remember that this is an unopened haunt. Like, literally no visitor / customer or whatever has seen it.
No.
Only haunters have seen it at this point.
Yeah.
And requesting that we keep it that way.
Mm-hmm.
I know from personal experience, there's not a lot of overlap between Haunt Weekly and the people who come to our haunt.
Right.
And it's the same thing with Garbage Horror and the haunt. Just isn't a lot of overlap. That's great. That's fine. So I don't have any worries about having it on like Haunt Weekly's page. But please don't share it too far and too wide, basically, is what I'm saying.
Yeah.
We're not putting it on the Bernie Baxter page, for example. We won't. Our customers, we want our visitors to be super surprised, obviously, so please help us with that. But yeah, we want to do what we can to support our community and help entertain during these very strange times.
Yeah.
And honestly, I'm actually really excited about this, and it was kind of hilarious because I put the idea on our Facebook page.
Mm-hmm.
Just casually saying, hey, would anyone be interested in a virtual haunt tour?
Yeah.
Literally became the most popular thing I've ever posted on Haunt Weekly's Facebook page ever.
Yeah, well, you know, this is what happens when, under those circumstances.
Like, literally within, 30 minutes, it had tons of likes and please, please, pleases, and I'm like, okay. You know, stupid for even asking. I get it.
Yeah.
I just wasn't sure that was the type of thing anyone would be interested in. And it's like I said, we know we're kind of in a unique situation.
Yeah.
Because we have a mostly complete, like I said, it'll be a little bit of a construction zone, a little bit filthy. But we get to demonstrate all the scares. We get to demonstrate some of the lighting. It'll be fun.
Yeah.
I'm really looking forward to it. We might even try to do one lights off and one lights on walkthrough. Okay. Or I think we should do the lights on first, and then let them see how it looks with the, I don't know.
I don't know.
We're making this up as we go.
Exactly. We're figuring it out.
It's really interesting. We watched a Christoph the Insulter live insult show. He's the guy that does the RenFest circuit as a professional comedian slash insulter, or I should say insulter slash comedian.
Yeah.
Probably better. And he did a live insulting. He roasted the fuck out of me.
Well, he does a lot of things.
Yeah.
He will be quick to remind you.
He is a multi-talented, multifaceted artist. He's an author. He is a storyteller.
Right.
He's not a model.
No, not that I know of.
His wife is.
Probably.
But anyways, but seriously, we watched his live stream and we were watching that going, yeah, okay, we need to figure some of the stuff out that they didn't figure out.
Yeah.
Before we go on. We know we got to figure some stuff out.
Yeah.
Anyways, on to the topic. The topic du jour this week is we wanted to provide some coronavirus, COVID, social distancing resources and updates for you guys.
Right.
Some things that can help you as haunters during these times.
Yes, and we are very hopeful that next week we'll be able to do a regular podcast. Yes, I know this is further down in the notes. I don't care. That you don't have to listen to this.
and I know you're sick of hearing it.
Yeah.
But honestly, it doesn't make sense to give these resources away after they happen.
Right.
In a lot of these cases.
Yeah.
Or B, later on, when you don't have as much time to exploit them. So getting them out of the way early and whatever's going on. Because right now it looks like we're going to be in the thick of this until at least the end of April. That's a month.
Right.
31 days when we're recording and publishing this.
No.
So yeah, my attitude is, yeah, I know it sucks. This is our third COVID episode in a row. And I am fully aware of that. And if this episode doesn't get a lot of listeners because of it, I get it. But at the same time, I think they're important episodes, and I feel like we'd be remiss if we didn't do them.
Right.
But I agree with you. We are going to try, unless like some actual shit catches fire. I mean, shit's on fire. I get it. But unless some actual shit catches on fire, we're going to try to come back with something new and something actual more normal.
Maybe fun and lighthearted.
Yeah, maybe we'll talk about plagues. No. The other plagues.
Yeah.
Excuse me. But yeah, we're loath to do this show, believe me. But that said, if we don't do it now, a lot of these resources are going to be gone.
Right.
And we don't want that.
Well, and some of the things that we're highlighting is something that I've really enjoyed seeing come out of this.
Uh-huh.
Being in online communities and having more online events for people to get together is really good. And I'm seeing a lot of people try new things and get more creative.
Yeah.
And, you know, I'm enjoying seeing what people are doing with their times.
And one of the things I've been enjoying personally has been that haunters, even though, I mean, haunters are kind of well set up for this because, yeah, we're a collective of likes, kindred spirits.
Right.
But we're very spread out already.
Yeah.
We exist all over the United States and Canada. There's very few localized concentrations that are high enough to actually have a quote-unquote social group,
you
know, other than like your haunt crew, you know what I mean? But an actual like true social group in one place.
Mm-hmm.
And so, yeah, video chats, message boards, Facebook groups have been a huge part of being a haunter for a long, long time.
Right.
And now we're seeing all that get ramped up. We're seeing these groups become more important. We're talking about a few of them. A lot more video chats. Haunt Chat has been doing a lot of face-to-face chats. A lot of
pretty
stuff.
Much every night for the past week.
Yeah, that is an excellent group of men and women who are a lot of fun to hang out with and learn from.
Yeah.
I really do enjoy my time, even with Troy. I'll admit it.
Oh, no.
No, but seriously, that you're right. We're pretty well set up for this. And honestly, this has just been us, like I said, raising what we already do because of our distance from one another to a new level. Mm-hmm. And one of those new levels is the HauntCon, new HauntCon conference. They're hosting a virtual conference called Haunt Connect.
Yes.
I can tell the name was come up with quickly, but...
Yeah, but,
but it's very effective. I'm not knocking it. It's just, they needed a name and they had one. But yeah, it is a virtual conference. Now, okay, because of the way the last episode recorded, we couldn't talk about the last one. The first weekend was last weekend. However, the big one is coming up.
Right.
This weekend is the one that features free virtual education, vendor showcases, networking opportunities. This one coming weekend, I think it's April 3rd and 4th, is the big weekend. Dates have lost all meaning to me.
Yes, 3rd and 4th.
But this sounds like a great thing. Now, if you're going to participate, you do have to sign up for it. It is free to attend, but you need to go to... bit.ly/hauntconnect20. That's bit.ly/hauntconnect20 to sign up. That's where you do your registration. It's a free form. It's a little jot form. Fill it out. And then you go to bit.ly/h20attendee, I know, to actually attend the events.
Yeah.
It's confusing. But yeah, if you just go to the HauntCon Facebook group, or the HauntBot Facebook group, Facebook page. Not everything on Facebook is a group, Jonathan.
Yeah.
They actually outline it there much more articulately than I did. And obviously, big support to these guys, Ganta Media, the Haunted Attractions Network, people who host our podcast and say nice things about us.
Yeah.
So, great idea. Awesome idea for the community, especially for the vendors.
Yeah. Yeah, in fact, whenever we heard Transworld was not happening when it was supposed to. At this point, we don't know what's happening with it. But, we were talking, and I was like, I really wish there were a way that we could do virtual vendor tours. Mm-hmm. And now it exists.
Yeah, and they've been doing that, and they're doing that here. But they've also been doing it on our next thing.
Right.
Which is Haunters Hangout and Haunters Toolbox. Now, we've talked about these groups before.
Yes.
And they've been around for a long, long, long time.
Yes.
So, I can harp on them a lot. The things to note here. One, they have a great collection of virtual events.
Yes.
If you want to know, this is where I learned about Haunt Connect.
Uh-huh.
You know?
No.
A lot of great virtual events are being posted there, large and small. Some have already happened. Some happened, like I said, the way last week's episode recorded. We missed some.
Right.
Some have already happened. We will definitely highlight any new ones we see as we move forward. Like I said, weekly podcast format has its limitations.
Yeah, and what we may do is we may start sharing some of these things out as they come up on our page.
Yeah, we really should. We should get better about the social media thing.
Yeah.
I am not good at social media. I have never claimed to be good at it. I know how to not completely fail at it, and that's the best I can do. But yeah, Scott Swenson and Haunters Against Hate have both had great posts about events that they're having. Like I said, both happened last... I'm sorry, Haunters Hangout had an event. I don't know where I got Haunters Against Hate, probably thinking ahead. But they had posts about events that happened. Sadly, they both happened last week. But here's the thing. If you have been putting off joining these groups...
Right.
If you're listening to this podcast and enjoying this podcast, A, I'm sorry.
Yeah.
Seek mental help after this current crisis ends.
Right.
But if you are, you definitely need to be in both of those groups. That's Haunters Hangout and Haunters Toolbox on Facebook. A quick Facebook search will find them both. They're very easy groups to join and get into. Yes, there is a lot of stuff in there. Yes, it can be a little bit overwhelming, but they're great resources, especially right now when people are posting these virtual events and virtual happenings.
Yeah.
And one such virtual happening...
Yes.
...is Quarantine Oween. Now, this isn't exclusively a Haunter thing.
No, it is not.
But it is. It's being pushed... in large part by Haunters.
Yes, that is accurate. This was started by Roxanne Hodes on Instagram. Her and her friends got together, and her Halloween friends were like, hey, what can we do? So there, if you get together, there are lots of virtual events going on March 31st for this. Mm-hmm. You're encouraged to dress up in costume, take short videos, take photos, and all with the hashtag QuarantinaWeen.
Yeah, and the haunt community seems to have taken to this just like that.
Yeah.
I mean, obviously, right?
Right. Yeah.
Oh, we get to put on costumes and take scary photos and share them on social media? Oh, twist my arm. You can hear all
that. Yeah, and if you have a haunt, you should definitely encourage, you know, your makeup artist or costume artist to participate and maybe tag you in along with those hashtags.
Yeah. I personally love this idea. And part of it is, I guess it's not technically as far away from Halloween as you can get. April is the end of April, so right. The technical furthest. But it's pretty goddamn close to as far away from Halloween as you can get in the year.
April doesn't have a 31.
Exactly. So, April, you fail the test, April. You should feel
exactly.
The only good thing named after you is April O'Neil.
Okay, then.
Failure of a month.
Yeah, but no. First saw this on...
Apologies to anyone named April listening.
Yeah. Or born in April.
Or born in April, yeah. So.
No, but I first saw it on Don't Be a Monster's Instagram. They were sharing it, and then I've seen a couple of other friends who are actually holding these virtual parties, which sound awesome.
Yeah.
So we'll see what happens there.
You know, honestly, I think everyone by now has discovered Zoom and Google Hangout.
Yeah.
I'm going to be honest. Between the two, I much prefer Google Hangout just because it is so much simpler.
Oh. Well, so I was on my first Zoom call today.
And
it worked really well. And it's got a lot of really neat features.
Yeah, but you have to install the Zoom app.
Probably, yeah.
I'm willing to wager, because you were using your new work laptop,
yeah,
it had Zoom pre-installed.
Yeah.
With Google Hangouts, there's no software to install, except on a phone, obviously, but...
Yeah, well, we'll have to look into that more later.
At least a mini topic.
Yeah.
But long story short, I'm pretty sure you're already familiar with most of these tools already. You've at least tried or dabbled with them by now. Take advantage of them. Have a QuarantinaWeen with some of your spooky friends.
Yeah.
Should be a great time.
Yeah.
Yeah, I love this idea. When I saw this, it's like, dude. Okay. Next up. Speaking of Don't Be a Monster, who was promoting, as you said, QuarantinaWeen, which, by the way, the hashtag is QuarantinaWeen. I think we said it once, but we're saying it again.
Mm-hmm.
Hashtag QuarantinaWeen. But next up, Don't Be a Monster virtual auction. Speaking of the people who were most directly harmed by the postponement, cancellation, whatever it is, of Trans World.
Right.
Don't Be a Monster depends upon the Trans World auction for a large portion of their income to do the things that they do.
Mm-hmm.
And so they are moving that auction virtually for the first time ever.
Yes, and which I am stoked about because I've always wanted to see their auction.
Yeah.
And like be able to bin stuff, and I am totally happy that it's moved online and that now I have a chance.
Yeah, I agree completely. I don't think we're going to win any bids, but...
No.
But I am excited to see everything. It'll be April 3rd through the 6th. They have not posted the link of where it's going to be yet. It's going to be on the Don't Be a Monster Facebook page, though.
Right. But they have been doing updates on what's going to be on auction, what they're going to have up for bid. So
yeah.
If you're interested in that, definitely go and check out the event. If you haven't liked their page already, why not?
Yeah.
they're a great organization.
Yeah, they are. They're a great organization. They got some really neat merch, too.
Yeah, they do.
This is definitely a good time to buy that Don't Be a Monster poster or mug or whatever.
Or a t-shirt.
T-shirt that you've had your eye on for a hot minute.
I think the t-shirts are new or they were a limited time, but I think they still have the hoodies.
I think they have some stuff, I know.
Yeah.
All right. Now, one thing I forgot to mention when talking about Haunter's Hangout was one of the things that they did right after the postponement of Trans World, and you can still find these posts in there. You don't have to scroll down a little bit, but they're there.
Yeah.
They invited vendors that were going to be at Trans World to do virtual booths and posts.
Yeah.
And so basically you'd go through and you'd see all these photos of the booth they'd planned to put up.
Right.
And it's really, really neat stuff. It was like a little mini trade show floor. Well, if you actually want to see what the vendors were offering, you can actually get Trans World 2020 vendor catalogs right now.
Yeah.
This is interesting.
It is interesting.
I have no idea how it's possible, but it seems to be legit, and everyone seems to be, you know, hyping it up. And honestly, it's supporting vendors.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So, it's from Pixel Pushers mm-hmm. is the site. They're $12.50, free shipping, and it's basically a chance to see all the vendors that would have been at Trans World and buy stuff from them.
Yeah, and I don't know what's in this catalog, if it's just the list of vendors and how to, like, see what they have online for offering.
Yeah, the site is unclear on that, I agree.
Yeah, or if it's actual pictures that vendors have submitted to be put in with their stuff.
Yeah.
But, yeah, it's definitely an interesting idea. I'm glad that the information's getting out there.
Oh, God, yes. Because, like I said, when you and I both had the same thought when we heard about the postponement, I don't know what it is anymore.
Yeah.
It's looking less and less likely every day, but
no.
But when Trans World announced they weren't going to be going on as planned, our first thought, we both looked at each other and went, oh God, the vendors.
Yeah.
We literally looked at each other and that was what we said.
Right.
Because they're the ones that, they depend upon Trans World. That is their big date, that's their big sales period is Trans World Weekend.
Right.
That's when they make most of their money.
Yeah.
That's when they get the orders that keeps them farming for the next 6 months, you know?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
And now that's suddenly gone. And so, once again, another chance to show your support for these vendors. We as an industry need these people.
Yeah.
We need these talented people to help build these awesome things.
Right.
And really, this kind of specialization is a big part of why the haunt industry has grown as big and as nice as it has.
Mm-hmm.
Is because people who do things really well, like make masks or do human limbs and so forth, can focus on that, and haunts can purchase from them.
Right, because there comes a time in every haunter's life where you realize, even though you want to learn how to do everything, you don't necessarily have the time or skills to do it.
Yeah.
So then you have to learn to other people who have already done it.
Yeah.
You know?
There's nothing wrong with that.
No, there isn't.
Yeah. Do the things you do well.
Yep.
And get help from others, man. There's no shame in getting help.
No, there isn't. Or supporting these businesses, especially during this time.
All right. So, yeah, once again, that's on Pixel Pushers, $12.50 with free shipping. Check it out.
Yeah.
Looks neat. All right, the final one is one that's actually, we've been told about it from a couple of people. Thank you to everyone who sent this one in.
Uh-huh.
We actually think, but Shudder, the horror streaming service,
right,
is free for 1 month. Use the code SHUTIN, SHUTIN. That's not our code, that's just a general code.
Right.
Everyone has access to that code. It's not like Haunt Weekly or anything.
No.
Realistically, it only saves you $5. It's not a very expensive streaming service. But they actually have a lot of neat stuff. I feel we've had a Shudder account for eons,
yeah.
It feels like.
Ellie's watched quite a bit of it.
Yeah. I feel guilty I haven't explored more with it. I really need to get in there. And I found a list with some really great suggestions. I want to check out that Dude Bro Massacre movie.
Yeah.
That just sounds fucking hilarious. I need that in my life.
Yeah, we may need some garbage horror at this moment.
Yeah. So, yeah, but seriously, they have tons of not garbage horrors, too.
Yeah.
Like that article I was telling them about, advertised The Love Witch, which we've seen, and it's a very interesting take on the 60s horror occult genre.
Yeah.
It's a very, very interesting film. Honestly, honestly, there's no reason not to get a Shudder account for right now. It's a great time to explore some horror movies and get some inspiration, if nothing else.
Yeah.
So, yeah, I mean, once again, sadly, not sponsored.
Right.
But yeah, the code SHUTIN, that's SHUTIN. All right, well, we've got a little bit of time left. So, one of the things that's been going on is a lot of the haunter groups, we're seeing the same questions.
Right.
Over and over and over, and so much so that some of those groups are now banning the questions.
Yeah.
And I don't blame them. I'm not saying they're wrong for doing it.
No, because a lot of it's revolving around what ifs, and right now we can't tell.
And you can only ask and discuss the same question so many times.
Right.
And exactly, you know, between that and the what ifs and all that, yeah, I don't blame them. I honestly probably would do the same thing in their shoes.
Yeah.
But that doesn't mean we can't briefly discuss them and maybe try to answer them for those who might have them, the best of our abilities. Once again, we are certainly not experts in viruses and things like that.
No, or how people recover for them, no. from them, or how the economy will be,
yeah.
or
so,
anything.
Yeah, we're not economists, we're not virologists, we're not any ists in this at all. So please just understand we're two lay people who, like everyone else, is stuck at home and thinking way too hard about these issues.
Yeah.
Take it there and leave it there, basically.
Mm-hmm.
But here are the question, three questions I keep seeing over and over and over and over and over and over again. Mm-hmm. First, how will this impact the haunt industry?
No.
We don't know. Next one.
No, we don't.
Well, the truth is there's a lot of factors at play. When will it end?
Right.
We know we're in for this at least through the end of April.
Yeah.
That just came down today here in Louisiana, that the stay-at-home order will stay in effect at least through the month of April.
Right.
So, and it could be even longer than that very, very easily. So we know at least through the end of April. But we really don't know when it's going to end. And even if we know where it's going to end in one place, we don't know where it's going to end everywhere.
Right.
Because different parts of this country are at different places with it.
Yeah.
Like I said, I think, are a couple weeks ahead of, say, Maryland, where my brother is.
Yeah.
But are we going to come out of it 2 weeks ahead? Or what's the deal? We don't know.
Yeah.
You know, so basically, we don't know when it's going to end. We also don't know what the economy is going to be like on the other side.
Right.
Ultimately, this is an entertainment and a luxury business, what
right.
we sell. Though it is a comfort product, I'll agree with anyone who says that. It ultimately is not an essential service to most people.
Right.
The result of that is entertainment expenses are usually the first to get cut during hard financial times. People stop going to movie theaters. People stop, you know, going to sporting events, spending lots of money on tickets for concerts and things like that. And haunted attractions get bitten that too.
Right. Now, if you have a home haunt or a yard walkthrough, you may see more traffic because of this.
Yeah. And one of the ideas I did like that from discussions we've had online with Troy, this was Troy's idea, was yeah. even if you don't normally have a yard display,
yeah.
have one.
Yeah.
Put one up. Because even if we're still in some kind of lockdown or people aren't comfortable coming and standing in a queue line or whatever,
right.
they can still drive by and social distance and see your yard display and get a wee bit of Halloween.
Right, exactly. And I was thinking about it. I think there's even a way to social distance trick-or-treating.
Oh, yeah. Trick-or-treating, yeah.
Yeah, I think that there is a way so that people can drive up and have, like, I don't know. I'm still working out the details, but there's got to be a way for people to be able to come up and, like, get candy without having to get out of their car and without having to touch things that other people have touched.
Yeah.
So.
In addition to the economy, we also don't know what people's attitudes will be. Are people going to come out of this wanting to French kiss everybody?
Yeah.
Are they going to come out of this still a little bit, you know, dicey about it?
Yeah, and I mean, that's one of the things we've seen some of our friends, not haunters, posting, is how much their view on how disgusting people really are has changed.
But then again, I've got a friend of mine who said, you know, Lydia, a friend named Lydia, who came and said, when this is over, I'm going out and French kissing every single one of my Facebook friends. And I'm like, well damn.
That's a lot of friends.
Hey, that's a lot of French kisses.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
Not going to complain. But yeah, so we don't know what the attitudes are going to be, and that's just it. We can kind of gauge what individual attitudes are going to be, but I'm talking more collectively.
Right.
We don't know what it's going to be.
No.
So we have not the foggiest what the actual impacts will be. This could be a boon for the haunt industry come September, October. It could be a disaster. It could be anything in between.
No.
We don't know. There are a few things that we do know, though. One is that a lot of spring, summer events are being moved into haunt season.
Yes.
Three separate musical festivals have been moved into haunt season-ish territory here.
Just here.
Just here. Just in New Orleans.
Yeah.
And these are three festivals that were supposed to happen spring and summer. Buku Fest is Labor Day weekend, which is early for haunt season, I know. But some haunts, with haunts opening earlier and earlier, it could collide with someone. But then you have, you know, French Quarter Fest, which is now first weekend of October.
Yeah.
And when did Jazz Fest move to again? It was sometime in...
It's in October, too.
It's in October? So, yeah, that... French Quarter Fest and Jazz Fest are two huge goddamn music festivals that are all weekend affairs and all night affairs.
Not to mention that Voodoo Fest already exists on Halloween weekend.
Yeah. And we've always had Voodoo Fest on the weekend before Halloween. It's usually not the weekend. If Halloween's on a weekend like today, it's usually the weekend before.
Yeah.
Like this year, rather, sorry. But if Halloween's on a Sunday, it'll be the 31st. Yeah, check on Voodoo Fest.
Yeah, I'll do that.
I'm talking out my ass.
Yeah. October 30th and November 1st.
Okay. So they are going to do it through November. Okay.
Yep.
But yeah, usually it's the weekend before Halloween. But no, it's going to be on Halloween weekend. And that's, once again, a big, huge music festival that some years gets a lot of interest. Didn't do a very good fucking job last year. The year I could have fucking gone.
Right.
Assholes.
I'm sure they planned it all around you.
Well, them's the motherfuckers that had Metallica in the middle of haunt season.
Yeah, I know.
I'm fucking salty as shit about that.
Yeah, well, it wasn't supposed to be Metallica to begin
with. No, they were last minute substitution.
For
Green Day. Green Day dropped out suddenly and Metallica stepped in. Which Green Day would have been nice, too.
Yeah, well.
Fuckers.
he needed help, so.
Yeah, he did. And I'm glad he got it. And I would have liked to have seen Green Day, too. It's not like it would have been much better.
No.
If it had been just Green Day, what I'm saying. Anyway, basically, the other thing we know for certain is that some pro haunts are not able to build right now.
No.
Or are very limited in what they can build.
Right.
For us home haunters, this isn't a big deal.
No.
We can go work on stuff in the garage right now.
Well, and a lot of home haunters, as we're reminded, build within September.
Yeah.
You know.
So, for us, it's not a huge deal. But for a lot of these pro haunts who have large groups of people coming together to work and build a haunt, like I know, like New Orleans, I can imagine, like New Orleans Nightmare. I don't know how they're impacted by this. I haven't spoken to anyone.
Right.
But they have a pretty decent sized crew that works year round.
Well, and so does 13th Gate.
Yeah. So, how are they building? How are they dealing with it? I don't know.
They may just not be able to change as much this year.
Yeah. And so, there may not be as much new, and that could be a thing. I mean, basically, this is a wait-and-see thing.
Yeah.
My advice right now is rather than trying to figure out how it's going to impact haunt season, just remember how big of an idiot you were 2 weeks ago about this and then realize how big of an idiot you are trying to predict 8 months down the... What are we talking about? 6-7 months down the road?
Yeah.
Yeah. So stop it. Mm-hmm. Second question. What about doing a virus-themed room or haunt?
Yeah. This is one that's been brought up around here a lot. Around our house, specifically.
Yeah, but we've also seen it in chats and on Haunters Hangout and elsewhere. Yeah. It's come up a couple of times.
Yeah.
My attitude is I would not do it in New Orleans, definitely.
No.
Because it's already too serious here. You're pretty much going to be hard-pressed to find someone that doesn't know somebody who knows somebody that died.
Yeah, I mean...
We're already in that circle.
Or who was just sick with it.
Or just, like, traumatically sick with it. Not, like, annoyingly sick with it. Traumatically sick.
Yeah. Like, we have a friend whose dad was in ICU with it.
Yeah.
You know.
Now, I don't know anyone directly, like, personal in my physical circle.
No.
That has had it, or... but we know someone's dad who was very sick with it.
Right.
So, yeah, to me, it would just be poor taste to do it. Especially if things get much worse, it's just going to be poor taste.
Yeah.
And you risk actually re-traumatizing people.
Yeah, especially if you've got, like, the really gross scenes or, you know, people coughing, people trying to cough on customers. That I'm definitely going to be looking at that light in a different light, no matter what. No matter what we come out of this on the other side. Yeah.
Yeah, there's a lot of stuff that's going to change, I think, in how people look at it.
Yeah.
I think a virus room this year is definitely going to, if it gets much worse than it is now, it's going to be poor taste and risk traumatizing people, basically.
Right.
Re-traumatizing people, I should say.
Yeah. No, I completely agree, and I'm very curious how the touch haunts are going to handle this.
Yeah, there's a lot of
things up in the air.
Yeah. Basically, though, I mean, if this coronavirus stuff stopped where it is today,
yeah,
I think there are parts of the country where you could get away with it.
Yeah.
Where it wouldn't be serious enough, not enough people got it, wasn't, you know what I mean?
Right.
You could probably get away with it in some places. But it's not stopping here.
No.
According to most projections, New Orleans, which, like I said, is a couple of weeks ahead of a lot of other parts of this country,
right,
is not projected to hit peak death toll until April 10th or 12th.
Right.
And we're recording this on March 30th, 2 weeks away.
Yeah.
And we've been in lockdown for 2.5 weeks.
Yeah.
You know, so something to think about. I mean, I don't know. I would not do it. I would not poke at that bear.
Nope.
There's tons of other scary things you can do. Maybe save this one for after some wounds have healed and some time has passed.
Yeah.
And when you do go back to doing a virus scene or doing some kind of hospitalization scene, make sure it's not actually a corona scene.
Yeah.
Because you can do a generic plague scene, like the bubonic plague scene at 13th Gate, for example.
Right. Yeah.
Which that's like one of the conversations we had actually when this whole thing started, because we had been sort of trying to needle at what was going to be next year's theme. We know what this year's theme is. We already built the goddamn haunt.
Yeah.
But we were kind of going around trying to figure out what next year's theme was. Well, I've always wanted to do something with New Orleans plagues.
Yeah.
Because New Orleans has had a shit ton of them, it turns out.
Yeah.
Like it's had like 5 deadly outbreaks of yellow fever.
Yeah.
Including one where, like, 8,000 people died and, like, only, like, 12,000 people lived in the fucking city, I think.
It's
had some hardcore shit happen. And it had the fucking bubonic plague in the 1910s.
Yeah. Yeah, we're not doing that in the next couple of years.
No, that's on hold.
In fact, I mean, you know, after this year, we'll probably go complete opposite of anything that has to deal with doctors.
Yeah. Well, we were going to do that anyway because we kind of overused it.
Yeah.
Under the best of circumstances. But no, I was thinking, because I had the idea of like a serial killer who like kills or maybe just wounds people and then hides them in the plague body pile.
Mm-hmm.
That's how he gets rid of his victims, is that way. But that was a neat idea, but no, that's not going to happen for a while.
Nope.
It's a good story. Good narrative in my brain hole, but no.
No, I do like the idea of, like I said on the podcast that we did with Chris Gay, of having a germaphobe character, someone who is constantly cleaning as customers touch things, you know, railings and things. But even that might be too much, depending on how this comes out.
Unless your goal of your haunt is to be edgy to the point of potentially harmful.
Right.
This is a bear you don't want to poke at, I think.
Yeah. Yeah.
Let your creativity go elsewhere for a while. Well, there's another argument. Okay, maybe people aren't going to be super scared. Maybe it won't be too much, but they'll be fucking bored of it.
That's true.
You're going to be fucking, I mean, you're sick of this third episode of this shit. I know you are. I'm watching you. I'm seeing you right now with the power of my mind's eye going, working around that talk. Yeah. Yeah, you know what? It's not going to get any better in fucking October.
No.
Just saying.
Yeah.
So another angle to think about why you don't see that. I think that's a good reason not to do it.
Yeah.
It's either going to be traumatic or going to be bored of it.
Yeah.
Neither response helps us.
Yeah.
Okay.
Or desensitized.
Yeah, exactly.
Exactly.
It's a lose.
Yeah.
All right. And the third thing I've seen is what changes in our haunt should we make to help with these issues. Basically, just go back and listen to the previous episode.
Yeah.
Chris Gay is an EMT and the volunteer coordinator, the volunteer first responder coordinator for his county. I'm trying to make sure I get his title at least better right.
Right.
he's on the front lines of this, literally.
Yes.
And he's getting reports and things like that. And he also runs Haunt Tech Tips, which is a great site. It's technically, haunttechtips.com takes you to the YouTube channel. It's technically a YouTube channel.
Yeah.
Where he builds neat haunt stuff.
Yeah.
And he is a haunter through and through. So he has the perfect overlap of knowledge between knowledge about what's going on and knowledge about haunting to be able to give some knowledge bombs here. And he drops a lot.
Yeah.
Over the course. It was literally, I'm sitting there going, Jesus, the whole time.
Yeah, well, I mean, he's mentioning things, and I'm like, I would have never thought of doing that. Yeah.
He mentioned things like, don't have body bags that people have to push out of the way.
Yeah, exactly.
Shit, we do that almost every year. We don't do it this year, thank God.
No, but, I mean, every year we do have some kind of tarp or something hanging at our entrance so that people can't just look back in from the exit.
Yeah.
We're going to have to fix that problem. We're going to have to solve that another way now.
Yeah. For right now, there's a tarp up just to keep rain out mostly, but...
Yeah.
Because we ain't got no door.
No. But...
We took that bugger off the hinges a while back.
Yeah. Yeah, that's been gone for years. But...
Who needs a garage door? We have a haunt.
Who needs a garage? Because we have a haunt. That's why we bought this house, specifically.
Yeah, fuck the inside of the house. It's ugly as piss. What's the garage like?
Exactly.
And it was. It was a very, very ugly house when we bought it.
Yeah.
Oh my God, it's still ugly in places.
Yeah.
We need to redo the flooring.
Yeah.
Every room is designed by a different blind person, I swear to God.
Yeah. Anyway.
Anyway. The point is, where was I going with all this? But no, Chris Gay had so many great ideas on improvements to make your haunt. Thoughts about what to do with the makeup room.
Right.
And the costuming.
Yeah.
Came up with the idea of getting a whole crap ton of those dry cleaner covers.
Mm-hmm.
So the costumes stay separated even if they're hanging on the same rack.
Right.
Things like that. Little things that you can do that are relatively inexpensive but can definitely help make your haunt less of a petri dish. Which, I mean, we joke about haunts being petri dishes all the time on the show.
Mm-hmm.
Been doing that for 226 episodes, apparently. And now it's like, yeah, maybe we shouldn't be okay with haunts being petri dishes.
Yeah.
You know? Both for actor and customer's sake.
Yeah, exactly.
So, yeah, that talk, Chris Gay, 225, hauntweekly.com is where you can find it. It's also probably in your iTunes feed. It's a great episode, Chris Gay. Did an amazing job. So much info there. And he said, and by the way, we hung up with him. And like the first sentence out of his mouth was, well, after we stopped recording, I should say, no, I didn't hang up.
Mm-hmm.
The first sentence out of it was, God damn it, I forgot to mention the nightmare that's escape rooms.
Yeah. Yeah.
And I'm like, oh shit.
Yeah, we haven't even talked about that.
Oh my God.
Yeah.
Oh, in the age of Corona, escape rooms. Oh, my God.
Yeah, the local one here is promising that they wipe down everything in the escape room between players.
No.
And I'm like, there's no way.
There's no fucking way.
No.
Literally no fucking way. No, it's impossible.
Because because you might wipe down the important play pieces.
Yeah.
But people touch everything.
And even the hard surfaces and things like that. But, I mean, people are touching your lampshades. People are touching your pictures on the wall.
Yeah,
might not
people
be part
are
of the game. People are touching everything.
Exactly. Because that's one of the, you know... That's
people
the
are feeling around on your floor with their fingertips trying to find...
Or under tables. That's the unpredictable nature of people in trying to solve puzzles that they have no idea
how to
solve.
And then you get the fact there's often kids in these rooms, and God knows kids touch every goddamn thing on the planet.
Mm-hmm.
If you have a square inch in your house that has not been touched by human hands, you do not have a 5-year-old. I'm going to tell you that right now. I don't have kids myself, but I have babysat and been around kids enough to know they touch everything.
Yeah.
It's how they explore the world.
Yep.
Just, they lead with their hands like Frankenstein, and it's in everything.
Yeah.
Frankenstein's monster, I should say. They're touching everything. Yeah, so yeah. I don't know.
And they aren't really concerned with germs.
Oh, they can't. They don't get the coronavirus.
Kids aren't. Yeah.
But, you know. So, yeah. The episode of Chris Gate, a great episode. Mm-hmm. I don't know what he would have said about escape rooms, but I don't think there is anything to say. I just don't have an answer.
No.
I don't think that answer exists.
No.
Sorry, guys. Well, that's all I have for this week. Thank you very much for joining us and putting up with us as we do a third episode of this. But we wanted to get a lot of these resources out to you as quickly as possible. We have, we're slating to do another, a regular episode next week. And then we've got the news, which I have no idea what that's going to look like. I'm just going to be honest now. Everything going on, Haunt News has not exactly, we're in the Haunt News, dry season anyway.
Mm-hmm.
And with everything going on, there just hasn't been anything happening. So we may have to improvise that news episode a little bit. But yeah, honestly, hope these resources help. Hope they are useful to you. And once again, happy haunting.
Yeah.
Well, once again, thank you very much for spending the past hour with us. You can find more Haunt Weekly at hauntweekly.com or Haunt Weekly on Twitter, Haunt Weekly on Facebook, and youtube.com/hauntweekly is our YouTube channel.
Mm-hmm.
You can also find us on iTunes, Google Play, and Stitcher. Until next time, I'm Jonathan.
I'm Crystal.
And this has been Haunt Weekly, episode 226, talking about virtual resources for while we're all in lockdown. We will see you guys next week.